Tonight, the Islanders meeting the Coyotes for the first time this season, coming in off back-to-back wins and starting the road trip with a win in Denver last night. And it took them a little bit to get going, fell behind 1-0 in this one.
Well, I was a little concerned for them because it was such an emotional win to go in and play Colorado that everybody knew was a great hockey team. But, you know, Kempe, a real nice move, backs off Pellick just because of his speed. And that's really, for me, the only shot that got by Leonard that, you know, I would say, gee, was it a screenshot? What was the deflection? Because after that particular shot, he was flawless. And Josh Hosang scores a tremendous goal. Set up Filppula earlier on. That didn't quite make it. And then the quick pass, there's a shot, deflection. But he doesn't stay behind. And then he comes out and he scores a tough angle goal. And I think that really changed the game around a little bit for the Islanders because it looked like they were going to be down a goal. And the Coyotes, they're looking for a little momentum. They didn't find it. Josh Hosang provided a little momentum for his team.
First NHL goal of the season, first since just before Thanksgiving last season, came at 17:04. Late in the period, it came after an unsuccessful power play for the Islanders, but able to kind of carry that momentum into 5-on-5 play, get the game tied up, and head into the second period. And Barry Trotz talked about it in the second period. That's when the Islanders took over control of the hockey game. They scored 2 out of the 3 goals.
And you love to see them play extended periods of time in the offensive zone, Brendan. We haven't always seen that with this Islander club, but in the second period, they were just completely dominant. Good passing, a little luck, but again, getting yourself into the shooting area, getting through the slot, getting some timely bounces, and then when you get advantage of it, and I think Barry was talking about that a little later on, the execution, the guys have had some chances, couldn't find a way to score on the goaltenders, but Brock Nelson in that position had absolutely no doubt about it. He finished it off, and a turnover over by the Coyotes, and Josh Bailey again holds the attention of the goaltender, and Anthony Beauvillier opens up one-timer, thank you very much, and he continues his hot play, not only against the Coyotes, but really with his team.
11th goal of the season for both Brock Nelson and Anthony Beauvillier, and now you can draw the line right down the middle for Anthony Beauvillier. The first 16 games, 1 goal. The last 16 games, he has 10. A remarkable run for Anthony Beauvillier, and that's all the scoring the Islanders would need, because in the third period, yes, they were on their heels a little bit, but every time that they needed a save, Robin Leonard was there. A little shaky at the start, but boy, he looked good as this game went along.
I thought he played really well. I liked his aggressiveness. He trusted his defensemen, his forwards, to be in position if there was any kind of rebounds. This was right off the bat. That was his opening save, and he just continued right on, as you mentioned, Brendan. After that initial goal, they had plenty of chances to score, the Coyotes, but Robin Leonard was equal to the challenge. And again, it was about his aggressive nature. We talked about it. He needed a couple of goals, a couple extra runs to kind of feel a little comfortable that maybe he had some room to make a mistake. He didn't make any mistakes at all, and finally the Islanders were able to give him a little leeway, but what a big game for him tonight. And you talk about a confidence builder for forwards, defensemen. This is a good one for him too.
First win since October 30th in Pittsburgh. That's a game he didn't even finish. He got hurt in that game, had to come out after 2 periods. It's been a long time for Robin Leonard since he picked up the victory. Strong performance tonight with 36 saves, and a strong performance all the way around for the New York Islanders, who've now started this trip. We talked about it being a crucial stretch of the schedule. They have an opportunity here to make it a very good trip with Vegas and Dallas still to play.
They really do, and the competition doesn't get any easier, that's for sure. Two teams that are playing extremely well, but you set yourself up, as you mentioned, Brendan, for a terrific road trip to sort of really enjoy Christmas. And you know, even if you split, you're 3-1 on a four-game road trip, so that sets itself up in itself to be very, very successful. And you know, and again, maintain the confidence and go home and enjoy your family and enjoy Christmas.